Now we will study lens. Lens is a transparent medium which has got two surfaces. From one surface the light will enter and from the other surface light will leave. Now this transparent medium is different than slab and prism. What is the difference? For first that we see the definitions first. Slab, prism and lens. In slab, both the surfaces are plane and parallel. In prism, the surfaces are plane but not parallel. If they are not parallel, how they are? They are inclined. So, not parallel, inclined. In lens, they are neither plane nor parallel. One curved surface and they are not parallel. If they are curved, they cannot be parallel. So, this is the basic difference between slab, prism and lens. Both plane, slab, both plane and inclined, prism, and at least one of them is curved, or both are curved, then it is a lens. Now, in the lens again we have categorization, and that categorization we can make by two type of characteristics. How it behaves with the light. There are two type of behavior with the light. One type of behavior, the light coming to the lens is directed towards one single point. That is known as converging action. These are parallel rays. We ask them to follow a lens, and after this all of them go to one point. All the energy will go to one point. This action is known as converging. And such lenses which are doing this are known as converging lenses. For all these lenses, the middle point will be thicker and the corners will be thinner. So, this will be the shape of the lenses. Okay, these are converging. Then there are other type of lenses. We put the lens here and this will go in this direction, in this direction. This action is known as diverging action. And such lenses are thin at the center and thick at the edges, thick at the circumference. And these are known as concave lenses. This is known as convex. So, converging angle, convex angle and diverging are concave lenses. So, there are two basic families of the lenses, convex and concave, converging and diverging. Now, in this family, there are different members according to shape. See that this lens we will call double convex. This is glass or any medium. Now this is thick at the center, thin at the edges, therefore it is a convex lens. But one side is plane, so we have given the name plano-convex. This is double convex. And then we have this third one, which is this type. This is also thick at the center, thin at the corners. One side is convex and one side is concave. We write it concavo, convex. Yes. So, all these three are doing this converging action. Therefore, all three belong to convex family, so their surname is convex. This side tells whether it is double, whether it is plano, or whether it is concavo. Similarly, we have a family of concave lenses. Concave will always be thin at the center and thick at the corners. See this one. This we call double concave. Then we have plano concave. And then we have this. This is convex, this is concave, but this is thin at the center and thick at the edges. Therefore, it is also belonging to the family concave, and this is a diverging lens. But one side is convex, so we call it convexo. Now, all these three have the surname concave. All these three are concave. All these three are diverging. So, the rays which are coming here parallel will be diverged. All will have the same action, diverging. Sometimes diverging will be more, sometimes diverging will be less, but all will diverge, therefore all are concave. So see, concave family, convex family. So a transparent medium which has at least one side curved is called a lens. Now, this lens has a converging action, that means it can bend the direction of light. This we need for the correction of our eyes. This we need for many other applications, to see the things larger, magnified. This we need to make telescope, microscope, and for many other uses. And for that, we have different definitions of it. Like, a very important definition is the focus. Here, when you have a lens, the parallel rays are coming here and all of them converge at a single point. This point is known as focus. In this case, all these parallel rays which are coming to the lens diverge in such a way that all appear to come from a single point. All these rays appear to come from a single point, and this point is known as focus. That is one focus. We will see which is the other principal focus, but focus is an important point here, and that shows the power. This ray which was going in this direction, it has been diverted into this direction. I have another lens here. This ray which was going in this direction is bent this much. Here it is bent this much. This is less bending and this is more bending. This lens is more powerful. This is less powerful. So, in what thing the power lies? Answer, in bending the ray. If the bend is slight, the power is less. If the bend is more, the power is more. this is more powerful, this is less powerful. If it is less powerful, its focal length is large. If it is more powerful, the focal length becomes small. So power is proportionate to 1 upon focal length, or we can say power is equal to 1 upon focal length. This is the relation between power and focal length, please remember. Okay, now having read all about this lens, how do we make it? We make this lens by putting medium, transparent medium like glass between the two dyes. And these are dyes like our plate of the teacup plate. That plate you have seen, take one plate, take other plate, join the two, fill up glass in that. Remove the plates, what you get is a lens. Now, these plates may have different radius of curvature. This may be a plate like this, this may be a plate like this. So the radius of curvature may be different. If the radius of curvature will be different, then its bending power becomes different. If the material, this transparent material, is different, then its bending power will be different. So power of a lens to bend a light depends upon refractive index of the medium and curvature of the surface. And now we will study in our next lecture what is the relation of refractive index and radius of curvature with power of the lens. And power of the lens is related to focal length. So we can say how radius of curvature and refractive index is related to focal length. There is a relation between the two, and that relation is used by those people who are making the lens by using the dyes of different radius of curvature. So that formula, that relation is known as lens maker's formula. So in our next topic, we will study lens maker's formula. Thank you.